Nee, nee, wir bleiben. We just stay here, right? Yep. Just say hello.
All right, how much time do we have? So I have time to...
Almost nothing. Oh, wait, it's we start. I think we are live.
Oh, are we live?
Yeah,
oh,
we are
man,
live.
I was on the...
well, nice. Welcome to the Seat Story Cup 3, powered by Need for Seat.
That's right, guys. We're here in Krefeld, Germany. I'm here with Dennis, the owner of Take TV. And this time around, we have an amazing weekend planned for you guys of great Hearthstone games, some fun personalities. And we've made some improvements this time around, haven't we?
Well, yes, I hope so. I don't know what are you talking about, but we thought a lot of about this event, how to improve it, have some fun stuff included.
That's right.
I hope the guys... I think the guys already had a lot of fun yesterday, playing poker as usual, but we also have consoles there. We can capture them. People can see what they play and so on. There will be some more stuff happening, and I think there will be a lot of fun stuff happening, actually.
It already has. You know, people saw our Toasts and Crypt streaming this morning from Crypt's channel, and now they're all over there writing in the chat together. Guys, I think something that I want to emphasize above everything else is that I've traveled around the world doing Hearthstone events. There's something that you can't replace, and that's atmosphere. And something here in Take TV's house, it's special, even going back to all the Home Story Cups from the past. So I'm really happy to be here. Home Story Cup is always great, but Sea Story Cup is where it's at. The third edition is going to be awesome. I'm playing in it too. Like, this is something that's absolutely unprecedented. People were like, what are you doing, Froden? Why are you playing?
Yeah, we're talking about a few facts. You are playing for the very first time in a big tournament, and I'm very happy you do that, and looking forward to seeing you how you can compete with the very best in the world. What are your expectations?
I expect to do about as average as a Tempo Storm player does in most tournaments, so I'm expecting to bow out maybe in the first day, but I'm definitely going to hop on the couch as soon as it happens.
Yeah, looking forward to that. And besides that, we have a great lineup. I think last time we already had like almost the very best players you can imagine.
Absolutely.
Once again, like all the great guys came over, just come to Krefeld here in Germany, and we have 4 days of Hearthstone group stages and so on. I think we will see a lot of great games and a lot of fun with the players entertaining each other and so on.
Yeah. Absolutely. And one thing that's also special about this event too is that there's actually going to be some crowdfunding that's available too.
Yeah.
50% of all the donations that go to the stream help go towards the prize pool. So even though it's $20,000 and there's a lot of money to be won, guys, if you donate, 50% of that also goes to the prize of whoever ends up taking it. We've had Strivecro win the first one, Savitz win the second one. So you do know that this is a Hall of Champions that they'll be entering.
Exactly. 50% goes to the prize pool. You can find it on taketv.net. There's like, you can see it in the donations. You can see who donated. Also what they actually wrote, if they have some greetings or whatever. And actually, there is a small goal already, which is...
We have incentives, right?
Right now, it's just one.
Okay.
Because we thought of an idea we had in a meeting, but I don't want to talk too much about it.
You shouldn't spoil it.
Yeah, okay. Actually, because I think this... Yeah, you should... Just wait for that. I think it's $23. It's just the first aim.
That's easy, man. I can give you 50 right here, and we'll just guarantee you that the 25% that goes to...
We wanted to start very low, that we hype the people a little bit, and guarantee this goal, because this goal, just, it will be around 8 p.m. That's
okay.
What I can say.
8 p.m. Central Summertime,
yeah,
right?
Okay. From now, what is it? In Germany, it's 2 p.m., so it's another...
So 6 hours?
Yeah.
All right.
Well,
it's going to be fun.
I can let you just know one thing. If you miss that time... You totally miss something which might be totally awkward or might be totally fun.
It will be. It's Hearthstone. It's esports. It's Hearthstone. It's going to be really awkward, but it's going to be memorable.
So I think we are done for the moment, and we actually go to our casters.
That's right. We have Krip and Artosis on the couch upstairs in the Take TV apartment.
Welcome to Sea Story 3, guys. In addition to Krip and Artosis, we're going to have a few guests, and the first guest here is Ekop.
What's up?
I don't believe we're playing today. We're not going
to
see you play.
No, I'm going to play tomorrow. I'm really looking forward to see all the action happening today. I've been looking forward to Seed Story Cup number 3 all year. One of the most well-received tournaments of all time.
Absolutely.
If not even the most well-received tournament of all time.
Well, there's a lot of stuff to get through. We're going to go over all the quick information at the start, but let's talk about our return here. Toasis, we haven't cast in a while.
No, we haven't, have we? That's going to be a lot of fun because you and I are both like basically the worst two players in this entire house. And
come on.
We have a lot of conflicting opinions on how to play as well, so I think that's going to be pretty much a blast. But I'm like super stoked to be here. This is... the most fun is stuff that Take puts on, both in StarCraft and in Hearthstone. So this is like one of those events that I want to do every single time, no matter what. And so far, so good. So this is going to be like pretty sick, guys. 4 days of
the
best Hearthstone that there is.
Yeah,
it's like, out of the Western scene, who are we missing? Only Colento and Trump? Is there like anyone else that's not going to be here?
They're not even that good.
They're not even that good.
Not even that good.
It doesn't even matter. Who cares?
I could take them both on at the same time.
Yeah, with which deck?
Oh, not in Hearthstone.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, I have no doubt about that. You're a big nerd, but
yeah. There's a lot of matches that are gonna get played. There's 32 players, and we're doing the round of 32. We're going to round of 16. I want to show you guys how all that stuff works, but I want to show you guys another way to check out the stream. I know a lot of you guys have probably just seen the stream originally on Twitch right now.
Yeah.
But TakeTV has their new website up. It's taketv.net, and you guys can see the stream from there, uh-huh, if you like. They have multi-Twitch functionality, and that's fairly relevant because they have actually two streams. So you can see, I'm not going to click on it now because I'm a little newbie with the site yet. I haven't messed around with it too much. But there is a B stream as well, and half of the games are going to be played there. Half of the games are going to be played here. Mm-hmm. It's going to be a lot of fun with the casting. They're going to have different people talk about the games that are being played on the other side, of course. And if you want to not miss a single moment of any of it, you are able to watch both at the same time, as well as all the relevant tournament information with the info, with the players and their decks. I guess we'll just go through these real quick. You guys can meet the players. They got all their photos and stuff, except this guy, I guess. I don't know. But you guys can see that the lineup is as good as it gets these days.
Yeah, it's pretty insane. Definitely going to be a very strong player taking home this tournament.
And it is important to know that on the website, on the player page, whenever a player is knocked out of the tournament, and we'll go over how that's going to happen shortly here, all of the decks will be posted. So
as soon as the player's out?
Yeah. So okay. If you guys really, really want to see like the good decks,
if you want to see the worst decks in the tournament, yeah, then go ahead and just grab them as soon as they get booted out.
Also on the website, you guys can check out the brackets and the schedule. The schedule is pretty simple. We're going to do, I think, half of the round of 32 today.
Yeah.
Half
right.
of the
group
round of 32
A,
tomorrow. And then the round of 16 on the
That's
third day.
That's right, yeah.
And the playoffs on the final day.
That's right.
Yeah, and should we go over the rules now?
Sure.
Okay, so this is a format where you have to win with three different decks. It's not like you can just lose a couple times and then reverse all kill with right. Face Hunter.
They call it a conquest.
Conquest, that's what we're calling
yeah.
it. Okay.
Yeah.
But that's the way it is. There's going to be one deck ban as well, so everyone's prepared an extra class for that. And
they've actually prepared, I think, two extra classes because the format changes a little bit as the tournament progresses.
Yeah, that's right. You actually have to submit a couple sets of decks. Like, if you hit the top eight, you're going to start playing more matches. I believe it starts at a best of seven then?
Yes.
It starts at best of five with one ban.
Mm-hmm.
And in top eight, it will be best of seven
yeah.
with one ban.
Yep.
Well, and the grand finals will be played in a best of nine mm-hmm. with one ban where you can revive one of your decks.
And that's reviving a conquest means you
win
can
twice.
Win more than once with the same deck. Mm-hmm. So let's say you play your first game. Oh, I don't know. The good deck is pretty good. Face Hunter?
That would be a pretty good deck.
And then if you
Grim
win.
Patron, Warrior Crypt?
Yeah.
Face Hunter.
This is the exciting part. Blackrock Mountain, as you all know, is out.
Yes.
And it's legal for this tournament. The first wing is legal for the group stages.
Yes.
But here's the kicker now. For the top eight, whoever makes it there, the players had to submit decklists separately for the top eight because, first of all, they have to submit five decklists. And second of all, the second wing...
Two rounds of five decks, you mean?
No. First it's four, then five.
Are you trying to make
it's
this more complicated?
Anyway, they have to submit five decks for the round of eight
yep.
if they get there. And for the round of eight, the second wing of Blackrock Mountain will actually be legal. So you're you might actually see some new tech cards, and this will be the first tournament where you can see it live.
Yeah, and all those decks actually had to be submitted last night.
Yeah, the crazy part.
People had to literally just guess.
Yeah, they have to guess how good these cards are in decks, or not, or just not play them.
That's right.
But for one, it is. Like one, it's probably actually the first like really serious tournament that actually has Blackrock cards in it to begin with, and
Pretty
on
much.
Top of that, it's like we're really Like, the players are probably not too happy about it, but I'm excited.
Oh, no, yeah. I don't really care if their feelings are hurt or it's a harder tournament for them. As long as I have more enjoyment casting and watching it, that's really what matters.
So that's exactly right. All the players had to submit the deck list for the round of 32 and their deck lists if they make it to the playoffs. Mm-hmm. And the deck list, if they make it to the playoffs, as ECOP said, can include the second week of Black Rock Mountain. But because they had to already submit them before the tournament even begins, they absolutely in no way can test these cards.
Yes, that is right. They just have to theorize.
I
hope that we see some of the new cards used.
Yeah.
The thing is, I would probably not even, unless there was a card that was so obvious, like Tarzan or something, I would not even bother. I would just be like, you know what?
People are saying there are some obvious cards. What do you think, Ecop?
Did you just call him Tarzan?
Yeah, he's the new guy that makes all your spells cost
less. Emperor Tarzan.
Yeah, Emperor Tarzan. He's the king of the jungle, dude. What? I mean, but yeah, if there was a card like that, I'd put in, but the ones that are coming. Are there any ones that you really like? I keep on hearing people talking about the imp BM, gang BM boss.
You'll see once I reach top 8.
Okay. Yeah, you're going to play Major Domo, and then someone's just going to kill you that turn. It's going to be sick.
Yeah, you can play Major Domo.
Yeah?
It's and we kind of joked about it.
Play BGH and then kill you.
It's maybe playable in Warrior with a lot of armor.
No, it erases armor.
Does it?
Yeah.
Oh. Yeah, someone told me that. Well, I guess it's not playable.
You know what? Someone just heard that, and they're like, oh, I already submitted my deck list. Sickest dead card.
Yeah,
but definitely something to look forward to on Sunday when the playoffs are happening.
That's right.
By the way, guys, because we still have a little bit of time here, hold on. I want to ask you guys your predictions on who's actually going to win the tournament, just real quick, because I love doing stuff like this. Who do you think is going to win the tournament, Crip? You can name like two people if you want. Because it's hard in Hearthstone.
Two people.
How about you?
I know.
Well, you know I'm biased, right? I would obviously always vote for myself, but if I...
You think you're going to win this tournament?
I'm fairly confident, honestly.
Oh, all right.
The less I prepare for a tournament, the better I actually perform at it. And I've been playing a lot of Heroes of the Storm lately, so...
Yes, you certainly have been. I see you on there all the time.
Oh, yeah. I did some preparation, though, obviously, as did everyone. But one of my favorites for this tournament would actually probably be, let me check really quick. I would actually say it's very unlikely that one of the previous winners, like Strafgor or Savis, will make it again.
Why is that unlikely?
It's just, I don't
because
know.
Because they already
did
things.
They already did it, and it's like,
I don't think you know how odds work, and suddenly you're
totally
not one of my picks to win.
If you already won a tournament, you wouldn't really care to do well the next time.
For some people, that's probably true. Like, after I beat your ass at BlizzCon, man, I did never win a tournament again, just didn't care enough.
I'm actually going to say it right now. It's
wasn't because I was bad.
If it's not me, it's going to be Ostkaka. That's my bet.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay, that's kind of cool. Did you have a pick?
Most of the tournaments that I've cast, actually all the tournaments that I've cast, I've seen Theis do extremely well in. I don't think we're going to see Theis today, I don't believe.
I don't think he's playing
today. I just haven't seen him at studio yet.
Yeah, so, I haven't either.
Yeah, but I think he's going to do really well.
Yeah,
and I don't know. Whenever I'm like live, and then Gera shows up, Gera like always does the best. Like I've only casted two of these events, and one of them he won at Bucharest, and the other one he got like third place in the WCA China.
Oh, okay.
But that was like as far as the foreigners made it.
Yeah. All right. I'm
his lucky
go.
Charm.
Maybe. We'll see if Kara can do that.
What do you think, Arthosis?
I always just say Tyson Strifecrow. That's like my automatic fallback. I love their play, so we'll see how that goes.
Some players are still getting in, though. Like, you guys have to understand, I don't know if all players are going to be like super fresh into their games, like right when
there's some jet lag nerds out here for sure.
Yeah.
You know, everyone that came in from America.
Oh, there's some of them there.
Only a couple players actually came from Asia. Like, I think Masan came from Korea, obviously, and... I think me and him are actually the only ones that... Oh, and Amaz. Yeah, we're the three that came over from there. And then there's, like, several Americans in here that should be jet-lagged also.
Mm-hmm. Now, the players are getting ready. I think we're going to have our first match, Reynad versus Savis.
Yeah, that's
Let's take it just one step at a time.
Yeah.
What do you think about this matchup?
Okay. I think that Savis beats Reynad every single time they play, and I expect this to go the same way.
I'd expect Ecop to say something different if... his last statement was true about winning tournaments, right? With the whole entropy of things, then Reynad would have to win this one.
No way. I obviously have to pull for my former Doghouse teammate, and so does Artosis.
Yeah.
Zabi is definitely a favorite going into this, especially with him having the momentum from the previous Seed Story Cup, right?
Right, right. He is the defending champion.
That's right.
Okay. Is it defending champion? Do you reclaim your title if you win again?
Yes, you do.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. It is the Seat Story Cup, right? So
yeah, the cup always looks the same.
Oh, it does?
Yeah, it does.
Okay.
Yeah, actually, it's the same trophy again. Like, how many of those does he really need? He could make it look like sick 3D, though, if he lined those up because they got, like, the hole in it and stuff.
Yeah.
I guess we don't have a shot of that, so you guys don't know what I'm talking about.
No, not quite.
And in the same group as Savis and Reynad, we're going to see later today, after that, okay, I guess, Vortex versus Powder. This is also going to be an exciting match.
Yeah, yeah, they're both quite good. There's really everyone in this tournament is quite, quite strong. How well do you guys think that Frodan will do, being his first big tournament?
Well, I think his group is actually kind of easy.
Who's the easiest in that group, would you say?
So he's got Soleil, Hyped, Lothar, and Frodan. That's the group.
Yeah. Today we're going to go, if we take a look at the group stage, we're going to go through half of the round of 32, and it's going to be group A, B, C, and D.
Mm-hmm.
And again, it's going to be split because we have two different streams. So we're going to take, I believe, group A and group B, while the other stream takes care of group C and group D. So we will actually not see Frodan play today, but hopefully we'll see him play in following day.
I hope so, man. I want him to show just how much harder it is to commentate Hearthstone than it is to play it. Oh, never mind. We actually changed it, guys. So we're actually going to show A and C.
So we do get to see Frodan.
Sick.
So after group A, which includes Savis, Vortex, Powder, and Reynad, you'll see group C on this channel with Lothar, Frodan, Zalay, and Hyped.
Okay.
And on the other stream, there will be group B with Xixo, Number Guy, Forsen, our dad, and Alesh.
I missed
I didn't
that
see our dad on that.
Why are people saying Forsen is dad or something?
Because of him being the Super Saiyan and all the plebs calling him dad.
Oh.
So the guys in his chat basically call him dad or something?
Yeah.
That's really weird. He is the least father-like figure I have ever met.
Maybe that's why Twitch chat relates to him so much.
Yeah.
And, of course, Group D, don't forget about Group D, which includes Strifecrow, Orange, Ostkaka, and Freaky. So definitely a very stacked group.
That's stacked group.
What do you think the most stacked group is?
Yeah, what's the group of death here?
I'm pretty sure it's actually Group D. A lot of underrated players. Strifecrow, obviously the big name there. But Orange and Ostkaka, as well as Freaky, well-regarded amongst all the pro players. Even though they might not be as popular with the public yet... Orange, of course, coming from his IEM Katowice win. Ostkaka, Freaky, obviously still looking out for their breakout performance, but they are really well-regarded amongst pros, so I would say this is like one of the toughest groups for sure.
What about E, though? Because it's got like Tice and Amaz and Gaara in there.
Oh, yeah, that's two of the guys.
Yeah, those are like...
I actually didn't look at the groups when I made the predictions. That actually makes it kind of unlikely that they both make it to the final, you know?
Yeah, especially when you got Amaz in there, too, who seems to go deep in just about every tournament he goes into.
He does all right.
Yeah, he does okay. He's pretty good at Cardstone.
Pretty good.
Mm. But guys, go out there, tell your friends. Let them know that Seat Story Cup has started. We're going to be here all day for 4 days. It's going to be sick. There's going to be so much Hearthstone that you don't even know what to do with yourself. Plenty of new decks, I'm sure. A really great format. I do like this format a lot more than that old format of just like, oh, I don't know. The 100 deck got 2 wins to start. I guess I'm good. it's gonna be pretty sick. Get out there on Reddit, Twitter, Facebook, you know, whatever type of social media you want to use. Go put it on your MySpace.
This is the one-in-a-time format that we're actually playing. You're probably not going to see this ever again because it's Conquest with Ben, which obviously doesn't happen ever.
Yeah, yeah. That's a...
It's kind of weird. Like many players were criticizing it, but it adds some level of... strategy to it.
To tell you the truth, really, in Hearthstone, I wouldn't mind if there was a different format, like, basically every tournament. I think that would keep it, like, really fresh as well. So I'm actually looking forward to this with that ban.
Yeah, any fresh format for me personally is always exciting to see.
Yeah.
I spoke to Strifecrew this morning, and he mentioned that he's quite a fan of Conquest because he feels like it's very similar to a ranked experience. Like when you just play ladder, you're basically just rolling dice on whatever deck you throw out there, and it doesn't
really matter. So they all have to kind of be able to beat stuff.
Yeah. So it's less of the tournament style decks, and that certainly, I think, favors a lot of different type of players. Mm-hmm. Because I think a lot of players know like which decks beat which decks, and they really, really prepare.
Yeah.
And Strifecrew's like, yeah, Conquest is awesome because I don't really have to prepare very much. Now, with the ban, that changes it a little bit, but because it's such a first, it's a little bit difficult to really guess.
Mm.
Yeah.
What type of strategy do you use, Ecop, in a tournament like this for putting out your decks?
Well, I could talk about the kind of strategies that I use, but obviously I would be revealing my strategies.
Okay, what type of strategy would a player use? It doesn't have to be your strategy.
Well, we've seen people try to, for example, tune their decks in order to like counter a specific class that your opponent might play. Mm. Right. For example, let's say your opponent plays the Dreaded Face Hunter. You expect your opponent to play the Dreaded Face Hunter. You just build a bunch of decks that are geared towards this matchup. And
then they can never get that
third
win or something.
Sure, you might lose against everything else, but as long as you beat that Hunter...
Because I guess you could actually beat the Hunter 3 times with your decks.
That's right.
I like
and,
it. It's a cool strat.
And with the ban, actually, there's an increased chance that players will actually bring the deck you expect them, you want them to bring, because they have to submit 4 classes instead of just 3. So it's more likely that you actually can succeed with that kind of strategy.
Yeah, that's really cool. Any other types that you like as far as the strategies go that you can use?
Well, you could obviously just go with whatever you're most comfortable with and play the decks that you are comfortable with grinding on ladder. And that's what most players are going for, I would say.
Mm-hmm. How do you feel just the Conquest format versus the regular format on like, let's get your opinion. Strifecrew likes it because, it's not as much to prepare, and that seems quite fair for... Because a lot of players participate in so many tournaments all the time where it just becomes a crazy time investment. And I can absolutely see it on that regard. But what do you think in terms of, the better player coming through the brackets with this format? Is it more or less likely?
I see good things and I see bad things in Conquest, personally. What I see in Conquest, which is good, is that... how it works while in the match, you have to play all your decks in order to win. So you have to master all your decks, and also it's kind of fair. It seems fairer because you cannot play one overpowered deck and beat everything with it. And unfortunately, because there's no ban in Conquest usually, and it just doesn't reward pre-match preparation as much with picking your classes, banning classes, preparing your decks. Often enough, you just have to prepare so much more before the match actually starts in the last Euro standing with the ban. Mm. So I kind of miss that element of strategy. But I guess Conquest, after the match starts, the Conquest is better, I would say.
Yeah, it seems more laddery than the other style. What do we call the other style? All this terminology has got me for a loop. Last Hero Standing. Okay, that's it. Yeah, that's that format. I got really bored of that after a while, I have to say.
Yeah, obviously it's
just
always nice to mix it up a little bit.
Ridiculous counter decks. I'm like, okay, well, I mean, it's Warrior against Freeze Mage.
Yeah, we had Last Hero Standing last year leading up to BlizzCon. This year, Blizzard wanted to shake it up, introduce a new format, and people really appreciate it, I would say. I'm really looking forward to see what Blizzard comes up with next. Mm. Maybe we will see another really exciting format that they will introduce.
I think the main advantage of the old format, just to throw it all out there, I think is that because it's different from ladder, people who already play a lot of Hearthstone, when they see a tournament, they see a lot of different decks, and they see a different type of gameplay than they're used to. With Conquest, it's more like ladder.
Yeah.
But I think right now it doesn't actually matter because ladder is completely up in the air with literally the middle of BlackRock coming out with new cards, and it's such a mess on ladder that it's a non-factor in this tournament. But in the general sense, that would be, I think, a pretty good advantage because I remember for a time combo drill used to be crazy in tournaments and nobody would play it on ladder.
Yeah.
I mean, we know it's at every other time it's been played on ladder, but in in general. Like that kind of stuff. It's nice to spice it up. So I see good things on both ends.
Yeah, I do like that about it as well, because that's where I get the ladder decks I normally play, unless I'm just putting a bunch of heal cards into a paladin deck. I just take like a tournament deck and then load it up. So pretty cool. So what card? I mean, I don't know. This is taking a little while to get the game started, so I'm gonna keep throwing some questions your guys' ways. What do you think is gonna be like the card of the tournament?
Oh, there's gonna be one answer to that and one answer only. I would say it's Emperor Tharizan. I think this card is so good and rewards so many different strategies. You just put it in every deck basically, except for aggro decks, and you can do so much amazing stuff with it. And cards that have not been playable that much just get that much better because of Tharizan. So you can just pull off some insane combos that were not even possible before. You can go for the good old just some examples. You can go for the good old Sylvanas Brawl. You can go for the good old Alexstrasza Charge.
Charge.
I would love it.
You can.
I loved that deck.
That deck was way better just because Alexstrasza removed all the armor before.
Yeah.
Like you have like an 80 life warrior. It's like, cool. Okay.
You're just limited by your imagination, basically, and the card pool.
Yeah, and what you have in your hand when you play them.
Recently, I have to tell you, during testing for this tournament, I actually tried out Druid, and I mulliganed everything. I had the worst hand ever. It was Innervate, Savage Roar, Force of Nature, along with the coin, obviously. And then I was like, okay, I lost this game. And then the first card I draw, Emperor Tharizan. And that was basically a turn 4 kill.
Yeah.
Wow.
This was crazy.
Yeah, he makes some crazy snares. You agree? Is it going to be Tharizan?
Well, I can't just agree. That would be no fun.
Okay, then what's going to be the card of the tournament?
I think Ikal might be right. But if he's not right, it'll be Lotheb, because most of the combos that Emperor enables, Lotheb kind of destroys. So I think with the rise of Emperor, we'll see the rise of Lotheb. And I think if every deck has each one, then Lotheb might be the one to win out.
Yeah, people were calling Emperor Tharizan the Lotheb of Blackrock Mountain. Yeah. So I think the comparison fits well, and those two will try to battle each other.
Yeah, there's just very few creature combos. The combos are always a spell with a creature or multiple spells together. So Lotheb just stops that from happening.
All right, now here's my follow-up question: how many Kazan Mystics are we gonna see?
Oh, there's actually mixed opinions on this one. I heard people say there's going to be a lot of Kazan Mystics based on the popularity of Mage and Hunter. But many people also said that, Warrior and Druid is on the rise, so Kazan Mystic obviously not good against those decks. We will see what actually will happen.
A lot of players mentioned that Druid may not be a very good tournament class in the Conquest format, as it was in the previous tournament. Will counter specific decks in a very direct way.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Combo Druid is just kind of maybe you win one, and, that's really all about it.
Yeah, but that was before Tharizan came out, I would say.
Of course,
That card, I think actually that Druid benefits most from Tharizan.
Yeah.
Because of all the, your hand always being kind of full with clunky cards, and then all those cards getting cheaper, it's just so good.
Yeah, I would say just about everything is good with Tharizan. All right, it looks like we're going to be getting this game going a little bit quickly now. That's pretty cool. I think we got to accept 4 minutes, it looks like, about, until we get going. But okay, so for card of the tournament, I was going to say Tharizan as well, but I got to switch it up. I'm wondering if it could be Kazan Mystic, because I am really liking things like Freeze right now. I have a feeling a lot of people are going to bring that.
Well, we played some Freeze Mage together earlier.
Yeah, I just killed the lightning this morning. It was pretty...
All right.
Crip, here's a question for you before any pros can intercede and give their opinion. How many Gang Up Rogue decks are we going to see in the tournament?
I still think it's good. we got pretty unlucky.
We got pretty slain this morning, but...
Yeah.
How many... Do you think anyone's going to bring it?
I think
it's... Because when I was asking the pros, they were just laughing at me.
I think a good ladder deck is one that just has very few bad matchups. Oh. And while Gang Up Rogue win rate against most matchups is marginally over 50, it also happens to not have really that many bad matchups. So
it's like a Druid deck or something.
it's just like a general control deck. I think some people might pick it as an option. I think it's unlikely because I've talked to the players, and there seems to be a very acute hate for that type of deck. But I'd like to be optimistic and say that maybe there's a few that think it has potential.
Okay.
Yeah. I also gave the good old Gang Up Rogue a try. It was kind of successful sometimes, but most of the times it was pretty bad for me.
Yeah.
Actually, I was playing it with Tinker's Sharpsword as well, and just to have like additional board clear with better blade flurries. Mm. And most of the time it just turned out I actually never won with Fatigue. Okay. Every time I won, it was just because I had damage. And the cold lights just drew me cards. That was the most
important. Well, you got to take those damage cards out so you can win with Fatigue. There's nothing that feels better than making your opponent use every card in his deck and he still loses.
It just gets so out of control when your opponent doesn't apply much pressure and you get gang up with Oracle. It just kind of, it's like a massive snowball that gets huge very quickly.
Yeah.
But in the decks where things don't line up very well, things just go very, very, very slowly. And it's a grind and, well, you usually don't win, but sometimes.
Yeah. Yeah. I have a feeling we're going to see almost zero, maybe like one Gang Up Rogue in this tournament based on what people have been saying. But I do think we're going to see a lot of Freeze Mage.
What other cards can we see from Blackrock Mountain? There's Resurrect.
See any Grim Patron Warriors?
Oh my god. Everyone, get in here!
You know about that deck well, right?
It's solid. A lot of people have said the deck is really good. I think it is pretty good. I think the matches that it doesn't do so well in are ones you don't really face too often. Like, it's horrifying against Control Warrior. But I don't know why. It's maybe just people really like playing the new stuff. Mm. But I haven't seen Control Warrior like on ladder in a very long time.
Yeah. Well, I mean, people, of course, do want to try the new cards. But, I mean, if we're going to see stuff like Freeze Mage, which I don't know. I keep going back to that because I'm like, Tarzan with Freeze Mage is so silly. Mm. It's just so ludicrously silly, yeah, the turns you can have as soon as you make, like, either burn spells or Alex draws in an ice block cheaper. It's like, oh, you just can't kill me and I can kill you so easy.
We learned earlier, apparently making Antonitis cost a lot less and then all the other spells.
Yeah, that is a good combo as well, actually. Yeah. And so that's why I'm like, how many Kezan Mystics are we going to see? Because I feel like that's going to be like such a good card here, or such a good deck, the Freeze Mage, which makes me think the Grim Patron Warrior is... I mean, aren't you going to want to have a regular warrior in your lineup, possibly? I don't know. Well, I guess it's such a different format as well that...
I don't even know if regular warrior can outlast Freeze Mage if they get a good draw now with Tarzan.
I guess that's true, yeah.
Pretty sure they can.
Yeah? You think consistently enough?
Tarzan's out for like 3 turns...
The problem is always the amount of damage you can deal. Mm-hmm. And mages usually always have the same amount of damage. Obviously, it all depends on how many fireballs you get from the Antonitis, but usually, even if you get like 4 fireballs from Antonitis, it's still not enough against regular warrior. Mm-hmm. Unfortunately.
Well, I mean, I guess the decks would have to line up like that in such a way in this type of format to actually get that matchup, so I guess it's not as big a deal as it was in the previous formats that we've seen a lot.
Yeah. But we'll see. It could be.
Yeah, it could be.
Now, out of the cards being released, just off memory, another one that a lot of people have been anticipating is, I think it's called Lava Shock.
Oh, yeah, the reset for Overload.
That'll be in the second wing.
Yes.
And generally, I think Shaman is a pretty, I don't know if to say undervalued or underrated, but it's certainly underplayed tournament class.
Yeah.
And I don't know, like, one with Conquest, it's like Shaman's just pretty good against most decks, which I think does... make it better in this type of format.
Yeah.
And it does get that extra card, which I'd actually say kind of sucks, but
yeah,
I don't know.
Shaman seems like kind of crappy sometimes, but a lot of tournaments that I've been at, it's just kind of popped up as the deck of the tournament. Like last seat story, like Savitz's Shaman deck was killer.
The double Doomhammer?
Yeah. It was absolutely killing.
Wait, wasn't it Reynad that like gave him a few comments about the double Doomhammer?
Oh yeah, he was saying was terrible and then he, you know, Savitz just like crushed his face with it.
So do you think there's actually still some bad blood between them leading into this match that we're going to have?
I don't think so.
I don't think Savitz has bad blood.
Maybe there's some that none would want to admit, but I don't think we'll see any of that come out.
No, probably not.
Probably not.
But okay, I think that we are finally getting some people added onto these accounts so that we can end up watching. Oh, a few more minutes, guys. Reynad made a boo-boo, so he's got to redo something.
He's already under the bus?
Oh, man.
Why did you do that? Man.
because I'm having to sit here and talk for days about the same cards over and over. So, all right. Shaman decks, will we see them here?
I think they're good. I think they fit the format well. And I think that's good enough. I think that'll just, some players will be like, well, let's bring Shaman. People are not expecting it. Why not?
What, will it be like a mech Shaman or like a more classic Shaman?
Anything is possible with Shaman. I've been playing Shaman recently with Maligos and just go for the good old Maligos Ancestral's Call.
Oh, you've been playing that deck. I've given that a try. Do you actually like that deck?
I do like it. It's unfortunately it's not good enough yet. Maybe Lava Shock is something that can change a little bit.
You think so?
Maybe.
Why would it change anything? Because I feel like if you actually use Lava Shock for its unoverloading ability, you'd basically have already wasted way too many burn cards.
Yeah, I guess it depends on what kind of overload cards you are playing. But I really like Maligos Shaman is really a deck that I want to succeed. Mm-hmm. Unfortunately, I don't see it succeeding anytime soon, which is unfortunate.
I think most of the success I've seen on Ladder, at least maybe in the last month or two, has been with just a very typical control Shaman and Neptulon having a lot of luck. Yeah, just a little more luck.
Pretty cool.
It's pretty cool.
Yeah,
there's a lot of ways to deal Shaman, and definitely a Shaman, because there's like no set build, does have the element of surprise on its side, unlike other decks that have established builds already. So despite Shaman maybe being slightly worse in with whatever it does compared to other classes, it does have this element of surprise, which is really important in tournaments often enough. That will give Shaman an edge sometimes. So I'm pretty sure, yeah, many players think Shaman is underrated, but many players also still like to go to the Shaman. Like, for example, Thais likes Shaman. Gara obviously likes Shaman.
I heard he's the best Shaman.
That's still back from his World of Warcraft days, but I guess he kept it moniker. Yeah.
I'm kind of curious about the element of surprise now that you brought it up. It's it is something that's always very, very important, very powerful in tournaments. And now with like the meta kind of changing on a daily basis a little bit, and the fact that it is a very prestigious tournament, how confident are you that you can actually guess what decks your opponents have in this tournament?
Ah, that's a good question.
I think that especially in a format like Conquest, people will just go to their comfort picks. So they're really, really easy to read, I would say, if you know beforehand which opponents you'll be playing. For example, I'm playing versus Life Coach. And Life Coach on stream, for example, he always plays those same decks. He plays Handlock, he plays Druid, and all that stuff. Like, and he also always brings some sort of mage to the tournaments. And like recently, it's been a lot of Mech Mage, I guess. And now he's also playing Tempo Mage along with the other Nihilum players. So I assume he's going to bring a variety of those decks. And other players, like, they have their go-to picks. Some players like Shaman a lot, some players like Rogue a lot. And you can always be sure that they will bring that deck. And obviously with, especially when one deck gets really popular, like Face Hunter, for example, on both ladder and in tournaments, then you can obviously expect many players to bring that deck as well.
Do you think Face Hunter will be the most popular deck of the tournament?
Yeah.
I certainly believe so. It's really powerful.
Why would you not bring Face Hunter to this?
Because Quick Shot isn't that good.
The problem with Face Hunter is this. It might be the most powerful deck in the whole format. That's true. But it's also the one that's most easy to counter. And as I said before, if you're building a lineup that's like geared towards beating a class that you can counter very well, then who knows? Maybe people are even going to be scared of even bringing Hunter. Obviously,
dodging that type of strategy for Conquest.
But as we all know, even that might backfire because Hunter is so damn powerful, it just can win against anything if it just gets a good draw.
Yeah.
And the counter deck just gets a bad draw once. So because you only have to win once with Hunter, as we know.
Yeah, and Hunter can definitely win once against anything. How much life did we gain in that one game? Like 60 life and it still beat us?
It had to be more than that.
It was like 60, maybe 70 life or so.
It was double gang up on anti-killbot. It was double shadow step on anti-killbot, and I think there was one vanished anti-killbot.
I think.
I just don't know how many were in the deck left, but all the ones that I had were played, and we lost to like Leroy Unleash combo from a face hunter.
Yeah.
Because we drew like double deadly poison in a row or something.
Wow.
It was crazy.
Just didn't draw the actual heal box.
Which
makes
me wonder.
There was like four cards left. He was done. He had no cards.
Would you ever just not bring Face Hunter to this tournament? Like, if you have four classes, it's just like, I feel like that just gets you a win.
I remember I made like a Heal Priest. It was a different type of Face Hunter a few weeks ago. But I remember like, oh, I was so confident because I could just out-heal Face Hunter. I had like every single heal card, even with some that you don't even expect. And I ended up losing because this Face Hunter was
Did
running
the,
Reckless
the troll,
Rocketeer.
The two-life guy?
No.
You didn't play him?
No, I think I had...
that's the only one I wouldn't expect.
No. But it's just insane. Like, the total damage a Face Hunter can do is absolutely crazy.
Yeah.
And if they get that extra, like, little board lead at the start, they just go face, and you're always behind trading, and it's just nothing you could do.
Yeah. So I'd say that's probably... I would be surprised if that's not the most played deck at the tournament. Mm. I'd be very surprised if we see even one Control Hunter. So stop playing that on the ladder, guys.
Apparently, yeah, apparently that's a thing, though, for, like, in the last couple days. Mm. Apparently Control Hunter has been doing well.
Really?
Yeah.
It's because people probably mulligan wrong.
According to Reddit.
Oh.
Oh, well, we know
I'll
they're
just,
always
I'll
right.
I'll just pass that responsibility away.
Yeah, I haven't seen it yet. Maybe on the lower ranks. Who knows?
Well, that's where we are, I think. So.
No, I think like people in chat were saying that like Control Hunter got like rank 1 or something recently.
It got rank 1?
Yeah.
Oh, that's pretty sick.
But, I mean, it's chat, so.
All right. Well, it looks like we're actually ready now to get these to get the game started. So,
oh, we're actually going to see Hearthstone?
That's only a very small part of this day is Hearthstone. We are going to have some Hearthstone games just to have something for people to watch rather than us on the couch while we talk about whatever it is we're going to talk about. So.
Okay. Well, that sounds good. Let's get into that.
Yeah, let's get this game started. I actually really want to see this. It's going to be Savitz against Reynad, so get out there. Let people know. Because this is going to be a lot of fun. Can Reynad... I believe Reynad hasn't beaten Savitz in a big tournament yet.
I can't recall that.
I was talking to Savitz last night. I think he said he has actually won like 3 times against Reynad in big tournaments.
Wow, that's many.
3 or 4, yeah.
So Reynad's finally looking for his revenge.
Yeah, well, it could happen.
What was it, 3 and 4? No. Savitz said 7. Savitz said he won the last 7 matches.
Oh, he's lost 7.
7, I think. Damn. By matches, he meant like pairings.
That's a lot. 7. Oh my god.
So I guess that's ladder included, I guess?
I don't know. I didn't bother to ask
ladder.
I mean, when it's 7, doesn't matter.
You lost to a bot several times this morning, so ladder doesn't count there. All right. Looks like we are getting this started, guys. We're polishing our spectacles at the moment. Paying the band. Cooking popcorn. All right, we're also learning how to spectate 2 at once. Here we go. It's going to be Savitz going up against Reynad. Reynad punched through styrofoam. That's great.
I think I may have not done this very well.
Yeah.
But we'll figure it out.
I'm not exactly sure. Hold on. Okay, so right now we have the information. We had Savitz banned Priest and Reynad... banned. Wait a minute. I think we actually have the images of them reversed from what it should be, I believe.
Savitz needs to reinvite again, I think. What to do?
What to do? I'm not too sure. I've never spectated.
It says Savitz twice. In the bottom left here. Okay, so Reynad is the mage right now. No. Savitz is the mage, but we have Reynad's name there, so hopefully we can get that switched pretty quickly here, because that's going to be a little bit mind-melty. But anyways, it is going to be Rogue, and he has Sprint here, going up against Mage. Okay, and the Mage deck, we actually aren't sure. We don't see the hand right now. So, anyways, it's the first game, guys. We'll get it.
All right. There's an Arcane Intellect. We know exactly what deck this is.
Yeah, it does look like it. Probably going to be a Freeze Mage. In the meantime, it looks like Reynad. Is this going to be an Oil Rogue? Anyone? Oil Rogue?
Most likely it's Oil Rogue.
Yeah.
It looks pretty consistent.
Seeing the Sprint kind of looks like that.
It's just, that's a Shade, isn't it?
That is a Shade.
That's not consistent with anything that I know.
Yeah, but that's probably like, you would imagine that Tempo Storm would bring a bit of tech, right? We've seen in the past sometimes Shade added to old Miracle decks and stuff just to have a minion that kind of stayed on the board. Because like, for instance, this Mage deck can't really deal with that.
Mm-hmm.
It'll just be bigger than it can deal with by the time it can play a Flame Strike or anything.
Yeah, but does that really matter? Rogue generally doesn't have too much life gain. And it really doesn't require too much. Oh, wow, the Shade's about to hit face.
Oh, yeah. He's just going to go for it. Well, he's got a pretty big board out there, so it makes sense. We're still trying to get the all the hands set up, guys. So don't worry about that. It'll be fixed relatively soon here.
Black Knight and Shade. Have you seen anything like this?
Whoa. Yeah, what is this? That's actually kind of catching me off guard a little bit.
Oh, wow. Yeah, I mean, I've seen some Black Knight, even pre-GVG in Rogue decks, actually.
Yeah.
So,
but he has Shade as well, so what do you put this deck on?
It's just, I guess, some tech against bigger Taunters in general, because Taunters tend to be really annoying for the Miracle Rogue, especially if they're big Taunters like the ones that Handlock can put out.
You think it's still like an Oil Rogue, though?
Yeah, it is. It definitely is.
Okay. Well, as far as Savitz goes, who knows what's in his hand. All right.
Wow.
That's a
you have to like that if you're the Rogue.
Yeah, definitely. That has to feel pretty nice.
And you're still pushing for so much damage.
Hmm. Well, he's going to take a lot here. Yeah, we'll have this fixed in a moment, guys. Sorry, once again. I think we're about to have the hands up finally. The hand for Savitz.
Pay attention, class.
Nope.
No? Ah, that's fine. I don't want to see it anyways. I'm just going to pretend I'm playing the Rogue here.
What to do? Yeah, we hope we are going to be able to fix this for the game two. For now, it seems like we are playing with hidden information.
Yeah.
Which is what you usually do in card games anyway.
Yeah, it should be like that.
Well, Freeze Mage is one of those classes where it seems like you're winning by a lot, and then you realize you can't win anymore. So as crazy as it's looking towards the Rogue's favor here, I have to say that this is anybody's game.
Yeah, in general, it's all about how much pressure the Rogue can put out in terms of minions, and then just finish off with spells, so you don't have to attack anymore. You don't have to run into ice barriers or stuff like that anymore.
Yeah, he's thinking of developing the Black Knight. I think that's a good play. I think next turn he can dagger up, prep the Tinker and Eviscerate.
Yeah, yeah. I love the Black Knight here because it's like even if he has.
He can do that.
Like, he will have a minion attacking next turn no matter what, basically.
He can do that and Blade Flurry. Next turn, the mage is dead.
Wow.
Yeah, but Savitz...
Well, if he has a second Blizzard or a...
Savitz has a grip full of cards. He has definitely a lot of solutions. The question is which one is the best.
What we don't see is that he has 4 Secrets, 2 Mad Scientists, and 2 Acolyte of Pain in there.
I think there's a Doomsayer in that Shredder.
Huh?
There's a Doomsayer in the Shredder.
A Doomsayer in the Shredder?
There's always that answer.
Yeah. That's actually a really good one. I would love to just ping that and it's a Doomsayer and just pass right there. I'd be like, all right, sup.
What? Oh, no. You have to do that and then drop your ice block and your ice barrier with it.
Yeah.
Oh, you can only do one. Yeah. Oh, Mad Scientist, ice block, ping Doomsayer.
Now, here's what you do. You Easy arcane game. Missiles here to take out that 4-1 and drop a Doomsayer, and then you drop...
Man, when's the last time we saw arcane missiles in a tournament?
In a tournament a very long time ago.
Was it actually a Seed Story Cup 1 even?
It might have been. It was probably in Nimsh's deck, if I had to guess.
Probably in Trump's deck with the Murloc, right?
Oh, God, he did have that.
The Hungry Crab, I mean.
He Hungry Crabbed me, and then he went like Thalnos missiles and cleared my board. It was the grossest thing I've ever seen.
Sorry to bring that one up.
Oh. Well, at least he gets a secret out of it.
Yes, wow, but the Rogue does push for lethal here.
Yeah, there is a secret, but the board has not been handled well, and this is devastating for the Freeze Mage usually. The longer those minions survive and are able to attack, actually, the easier it is for the Rogue to just finish the game with spells.
Right now, you really just try to push for as much damage as you can, and if it's Ice Block, you want to really get them as low as possible.
Yeah. Obviously, you want to line that up at 1 health if possible.
Oh, gets the Sharp Sword Oil buff on a minion that can actually attack, which is obviously good.
It's actually the best minion that can attack because it's the one that doesn't get pinged down instantly.
Oh, yeah, that's true. That's a good point. All right, well, I mean, he's obviously going to pop this. That's not hard.
Yeah, it looks like it's a pop at 2 life.
Okay. Saviz is not even guaranteed to have Ice Block there. It could also be Ice Barrier. Mm-hmm.
Well, I guess we'll see when this little Murloc charges in, huh?
Well, if it's Ice Barrier, he's dead because Blade Flayer Eviscerate kills him.
That's right.
What if it's Spellbender, guys?
No, I think what you do is you just attack with everything, get him to proc at 2 life with the Murloc, so the Murloc attacks last, and if it's not Ice Block, he's dead.
It is Ice Barrier.
Oh, game over then.
Oh. Well then. And that's it. He just needs to actually do it.
Wait, did I miss something?
Whoa, that was a pretty snipey move. Okay. Wait a minute.
He missed lethal.
He could have done four more.
He missed lethal.
And, no, yeah, he definitely missed lethal there.
The rope showing its effect once again on Reynard.
Ouch.
I mean, we've seen Reynard make some misplays once the rope hits the wow. board, but this one in such a high caliber match in the first match of the tournament already, kind of tough.
Wouldn't it be crazy if Saviz brings back the game here?
Well, he has Ice Block if he wants to do it.
Oh, he has a secret, so
wow.
It might be Ice Block indeed.
If he comes back from here, Reynard is not going to be a happy boy.
Unfortunately, the Doomsayer is not going to stand for long, because it dies to the Blade Fury right away.
God, he has like lethal in a trillion ways here.
Yeah, how do you come back from this situation as a Freeze Mage?
Yeah, you can't really. The only way to heal yourself is Alexstrasza right now.
No, some Freeze Mages use the bots.
Like, yeah, I guess
if you have another Ice Nova and a heal bot, you can stay alive.
Yeah, you could have something like that. Could he'll probably do something like freeze his face. Oh no, he's just dead then. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, I mean, he was supposed to lose this game.
You would need a really extreme, like, set of cards.
Indeed.
So Reynard eventually closing this game out. Despite making a mistake, not getting punished for it. And, taking the lead 1-0 over Saviz.
Missing lethal.
In an unfavorable matchup, usually. Like, usually the Freeze Mage is favored against the Rogue. So Reynard definitely happy to take that game.
Yeah, so that's a nice
in my experience, playing Arena, actually, if you make a lot of mistakes or play just generally not very well, you tend to win.
Is that right?
Yeah.
I don't play Arena because it sucks, so I wouldn't be able to know.
Yeah, maybe Reynard learned a lesson from WCA, where Chinese players regularly missed lethal in order to like win the series after that.
Yes, that did happen. But, I mean, truth was, it was a high-pressure turn. And in Hearthstone, it's not always easy to see, the play. Unfortunately for Reynard, it happened at the start of a fairly good
tournament. Well, he still won the game, so that probably bodes well, right?
Yeah, we'll just forget about it, I guess, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Just forget about it, whatever.
He only got
in last night, so like he's actually jet-lagged here for sure.
Yeah.
Because he came from America, so mostly Europeans here, but... Some people do have to
All right, so again, we're going to see the Conquest mode in action here. The deck that won cannot be played. So now we're going to see Saviz.
Why did he queue it up then?
We're just testing if Spectator mode actually works.
Okay, never mind. They just queued up the same decks. I'm like, guys, this doesn't make sense.
Okay. Well, I see some cards upside down, so I'm pretty happy about that.
All right, so... Okay, everything is all set. We should be able to get into our next match here. Okay, let's try to remember what decks. So, basically, Saviz had banned the Priest deck, which is kind of interesting. Any thoughts on that?
I didn't know about that. Where were the bans?
He banned Priest, and then Reynard banned... Oh, I just can't think of it now. What did he ban?
I don't even see the bans.
Yeah, they were up on the overlay.
Okay,
so I'll take a look again when.
And do you know what classes they still play?
I can't remember. There was too much. It was mayhem at the beginning of the game. I made a caster mistake, just like Reynard made a play mistake. Should have wrote that stuff
down. I guess we casted really well from now on.
Yeah. Well, we still won that cast.
Yeah.
It's over, and we're not.
Casters always win.
That's actually true.
Yeah.
I'm always in the finals.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, all right. We'll get into that next one.
But what I was saying was with the format, we probably are going to see Saviz like replay Mage.
You think that's just the way to do it?
He has the option to change his deck.
You think it's a good one? I think Freeze Mage just does pretty well against most decks. And with the Rogue out,
Just a lot of mind games included. Yeah. Obviously, both players know which classes the opponent has. So does Savis expect Reynard to pick a counter for the freeze or?
Whoa, that's a high main.
Not.
Well, that would mean mid-range Hunter, wouldn't it? Okay, so yeah, it's Reynard's Priest is banned and Savit's Druid was banned. And I think they... Okay, I'm not sure why we have the red X over the mage. Maybe that's just going to count the losses for the deck or something like that.
Yeah, I had it inversely.
Oh, okay, it's actually just a little... overlay problem. Don't worry about it, guys. Anyways, this is very interesting to me. He's playing Quick Shot in the deck that has Savannah Hyman.
Yeah, it seems like a mid-range Hunter, but with Quick Shot. Quick Shot, obviously, a good card in itself. Even if you don't have an empty hand, it's still like a Dark Bomb.
Yeah, very much so. That's a good way to put it. But, okay, so... mid-range Hunter with Quick Shot, using it like it's a Dark Bomb. And do you think he has any like crazy tech in this? Because you were saying, Crip, actually, that you would probably just pick the mage again because it's kind of good against everything. Like, could we see a flare?
Nah, flare sucks.
Yeah. Well, in this case, it wouldn't, would it? It would be pretty awesome.
Well, we kind of don't have a perfect system here yet. We still don't see the mages cards on the mainstream, but I can tell you guys that he has a Frost Nova, Pyroblast, Fireball, Alstraza, Ice Barrier, and Arcane Intellect.
That's interesting. You didn't actually read those in order. You jumped around just a little bit.
Yeah.
That's the way your brain works, huh? That's funny.
Did I read it in order?
No, you read 1, 2, 4, 3, 5, 6.
Oh, okay. Well, Alistraz is not really that important.
No, I guess not. Definitely. Something that changes life points by up to 15 is definitely not that important.
Well, it's never going to do the full 15.
No, certainly.
Actually, it might, yeah. Hunter might be at 30.
Or Mage could be at 1.
That'd be 14, though.
Yes, I suppose.
So, the Web Spinners. We're going to see some dice rolls here.
See some King Crushes.
You think King Crush is actually relevant?
King Crush is
King Crush relevant.
Relevant
in this match?
Yeah, it's a charge minion.
Yeah, it's alright.
It's Freeze Mage.
It's alright.
What? It's alright. Okay. It's fantastic. Charge.
Fantastic. I'd say Gazrilla would be fantastic. Because it's really hard to deal with for Freeze Mage.
It would be good. It would be good as well. But, I mean, charge is important, right? Eh.
Oh, he gets the Malorn. So Druid minions in Hunter. Not bad.
Wow. He'll never get decked now.
Well, it's going to be pretty hard to get rid of that Hunter's Mark, I think. Now with two Quick Shots, it's pretty obvious to use one.
Well, that's a lot of damage going down here on Savitz. Dude, this could be the first win here for Reynard against Savitz in tournament. Wouldn't that be nice?
Well, you have to win three games, and sometimes that... That's just really hard to do when you're up 2-0. Sometimes you just end 2 and then they beat you 3 times.
Yeah, I guess that happens sometimes, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does.
Are you alluding to something that happened in the past?
Did it?
I don't know. That's what I'm trying to remember. I'm like, I don't know.
But it does happen.
You have such a smile looking at me.
It does happen quite a lot.
Yeah.
What to do? What to do?
All right, well, we still don't have those mage cards there, but... guys, he has like an Arcane Intellect, Frostbolt, that type of stuff right now.
That type of stuff.
Yeah, you know.
Cards that draw and cards that do face damage.
Or damage to minions.
Yeah. You're not happy when they do
that. He's got a Healbot in
there. There's a Healbot. Telling you, Healbot tech.
Yeah, Healbot tech is like really good and everything. Healbot is like the coolest new card, don't you think?
I just think with Tharson, a lot of decks are spell-based, and sometimes it's actually pretty hard to even make use of one Ice Barrier. And with two, I think it's actually better just drop an Ice Barrier and put a Healbot.
Okay.
I made the change earlier. Yeah. I think it makes sense.
Yeah. Can't argue with it.
Well, high main, you don't want to see that when you're playing when you're playing this mage deck.
Yeah. Let's hope that he has a Polymorph or something.
I doubt it.
I think at this point he has to stall and basically race.
Yeah, usually the only way to stop a Hymen is just by freezing it. That's exactly what Savvy is going to do right now.
All right, well, good enough. There's nothing in his... Oh, wait, no, he does have a... Actually, that little Hunter's Mark.
Yeah,
so
Hunter's
he
Mark
deal
Quick
with
Shot
it.
Or a Hunter's Mark Juggler is possible.
Would you risk the Jug? Could Jugs
oh,
do
yeah,
it?
Oh, yeah, that's right.
That's a
you'd
one
have,
and
you'd
three.
Have to play, you'd have to play the six mana crystals into minions for her to get one Juggle.
Yeah, you gotta actually just not play any games here and use the Quick Shot. All right, well, that is four Death Rattle minions right there. Where is my... What's Scarlet Purifier? Where is my Scarlet Purifier?
Scarlet Purifier?
Yeah.
That's a Paladin card, isn't it?
Yeah.
Of course, yeah. That's why you got to play that one Unstable Portal so you can pick him up here.
My best purification ever was against turn one and turn two Zombie Chow. I equalated it on three. Scarlet Purified the board.
Wow. 10 life gain.
Wow. That's fantastic.
It's one of the highlights. It's so rare that it actually does anything useful.
So true.
Yeah. It's one of those cards that's like, oh man, finally someone encountered Death Rattle creatures. Like, not really, no.
No.
Maybe if it did like four damage.
Yeah.
What to do?
Well, the Death Rattle creatures just replace themselves with other creatures that don't have Death Rattle. It's like, I don't know.
Or actually... Death Rattle creatures that replace themselves with creatures that do have Death Rattle.
You know, I tried to use that card quite a bit, and all I did with it every time is deal 2 damage to Sludge Belcher. It was so bad.
You've never been victimized by the piloted Sky Golem into piloted Shredder into Haunted Creeper?
I did.
Yeah, I've experienced that.
You've experienced that?
I've experienced that, actually.
I experienced something I don't even bring up anymore because everyone tells me I'm lying.
You're lying.
Clearly.
Another
Hunter's
Mark.
Oh, wow. Two Hunter's Marks.
Wow.
That's very interesting, isn't it?
Yeah, indeed. I guess it's a really good way for him to deal with bigger minions because usually you don't want to run your big minions into your enemy's big minions. You want to use them to actually go for face here. Mm-hmm. So this Hunter's Mark is most likely the best way of actually getting rid of bigger minions along with jugglers and haunted creepers.
Yeah, it's... It's kind of neat, and like, you know, even though it's...
I think we're really just missing the big point here.
Where's the big point?
Alistraza comes down, the Hunter's no chance of doing anything.
I suppose, yeah.
Yeah, now both Hunter's Marks are gone. The only way to kill is by attacking it, or kill commanding it, I guess, as well.
No, I mean, if Mad Scientist gets an ice block, how does the Hunter win right now?
Kazan Mystic.
Oh, we actually see that there's also a freezing trap.
Oh, and there
board.
It is.
Wow. That freezing trap is so big right now. Actually, freezing trap is the only thing.
Oh, is it freezing?
Yeah.
Of course it is.
Freezing trap is something that stops Alistraza, actually.
It stops. So he's ended up drawing ice block, but had he not drawn ice block, the mad scientist could not get that attack in.
Yeah.
Well, to actually he trigger himself.
Frostbolt his own dude as well.
Yeah, but how would you know that it's actually a freeze trap?
Well, actually, if you already see Savannah High Main, you have to actually assume, right, that it's
yeah,
a freeze trap.
Generally, the most popular traps in mid-range Hunter are freezing traps.
Yeah.
But I think they always run more than one type. Like, usually you run, like, freeze and a snake or freeze and explosive, no?
Yeah, it's usually two freeze or two freeze and a snake.
Yeah. I don't really see explosive in mid-range Hunter anymore.
Yeah, because...
What's the chance that it's a misdirection? He's really tricking us all.
No way.
That's my favorite. That's the most fun RNG right there.
Yeah, I mean, it's... We used to see, like, that stuff in really, really early tournaments, I think.
Yeah.
I just remember there was, like, a mountain giant that ran into another mountain giant in one of those tournaments. But that's about it.
Mm-hmm.
And that's long forgotten now.
Yeah. Good old days.
Oh, wow.
Well, that's a card right there.
One of the essential cards to get against Freeze Mage in general
when
you're playing any type of deck. That's the Lothep right there.
And also one of the cards that you guys were saying might be a card of the tournament.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It just cripples Freeze Mage so much and basically gives you an extra turn.
Yeah. It's like the scariest card when you're playing one of these spell-heavy decks.
Well, right now we do have Alistraza, but you need two turns to actually kill your opponent, and that's what's kind of tricky here.
Mm. Well, is he going to kill off this 1-2? Because you can see that Savitz knows that this is a freezing trap.
Actually, is there a fireball down? I feel like if Savitz draws a fireball, he's 100% chance to win.
Yeah, I don't know. He hasn't used it yet this game. I'm just wondering if Reynad will actually take out the Acolyte here to prevent another Ice Block. But then he loses like 4 damage if he does that. Oh, wait, no, but he could get a juggle off that Knife Juggler. Come on, Rope Nad, do it. All right, he did it. There you go.
Oh, Alistraz time. What?
That's kind of interesting.
I would totally Alistraz here.
Well, he clears, like, a lot of stuff by doing this. Yeah. And I guess that he'll get the Ice Barrier, which just kind of, like, negates this 9 damage guy pretty much.
Oh, the Juggler actually procced on the Explosive Sheep, so Savitz doesn't have to enable it himself.
Oh, that's nice.
I wonder.
Wait, was there a misplay? Shouldn't he have attacked? Oh, wait, no. No, never mind. That's a freezing trap.
Yep.
Wow, and right now Savitz just got back into the game?
Yeah.
I think he was always in this game.
Well, on board, I guess.
Yeah. Take a while to cut through that.
He's burned, I think. We messed around with production a bit, so I'm a little bit distracted here, but I think he actually burned both Ice Lances already.
He definitely used one.
Yeah, he definitely used one, but I think he may have used another as well.
Yeah, maybe we missed that part if he did.
All right, well, Reyna's thinking about the Lotha ping.
I see.
Seems fine.
Yeah. Well, that's that forces him right into Alistraza.
Cool.
And he actually drew the Ice Block. That's like an extra turn that he can buy himself later on. So that's nice, as long as we don't see a Kazan or a Flare.
I think you actually Alistraza.
Huh?
Thank you, Alistraza.
Oh, of course. What else would you do?
I bring life.
Like Frostbolt them.
Well, it's not great right now because you can trigger block and kill off Alistraza, and that makes a little bit of an issue.
But you don't need to kill off Alistraza because you have a freezing trap. Yeah.
That doesn't seem very good. Okay, so that was confirmed not good from Reynad.
Yeah.
Okay.
Huh. Is there, like, a reason you would want to kill this Alistraza?
You think there might be some charge creature tech in the new Savitz Freeze Mage?
He plays one Wolf Rider.
Sick. What about a boar? Value boar.
Value boar, okay. He plays one South Sea Deckhand and a Blink Chon.
So we see right here the freezing trap will not enable Alistraza to attack at all.
Oh, you got Ice Block again.
Oh, wait, if he goes Archmage Ice Block, the next turn he has 15. Easy peasy.
No.
Oh, wait, no, that's not a fireball.
Ice Block stays alive. Ugh. I mean, if the Archmage stays alive.
Yeah, yeah.
Which it obviously won't.
No, of course. I just glanced at the Pyroblast and thought it was a fireball.
But I do believe he has a fireball in his deck.
Yeah, so he could definitely top deck that. How many cards does he have left? Let's check. 8. Hey, it's 1 and 8. What's that, like 15%? No. Yeah, it is. I did sick math on stream for the first time. Look at that.
1 and 8 is 12.5%.
12.5.
Is it?
Yeah.
No, it's 15. I was just
Yeah, I know it is. Okay.
It's totally 15.
Oh, man, Crip, you must be so embarrassed right now. Guys, he is so red in the face. Oh, my God. It's okay, Crip.
Yep.
Oh, Dan.
Well, eh. And this is why you play Flair, boys and girls.
Even if he doesn't draw Fireball, he can actually kill off the Shredder, get a Doomseer and Toptic, a heal to stay alive.
If I don't think he has maybe another heal bot. No, there's no way.
I absolutely would not have killed off my Shredder there.
Yeah, I would agree that I would not do that, but I mean, there's like, he can only lose to two Fireballs and a Frostbolt.
So
wait, is there another
Ice
Lance? Another Ice Lance does it too, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does.
Yeah.
No.
7 plus
no,
6 plus
no,
1.
No, it doesn't. No, it doesn't. It's one short.
Oh, yeah, that's 14. You can't outmaster the Lothep, silly guy.
But it's a beast.
Oh, and there it is.
Oh, my God.
What? God. Wow.
Hearthstone.
I want to see Raynad. Can I see Raynad?
Well, you can see him on the screen right here.
Oh.
That was a sick top deck right there, fellas.
Yeah, it's exactly the card Savis needed to win. And he got it, tying up the series 1-1.
That was the only card that could
beat
me.
That was pretty vicious. That was vicious. It did seem like Raynad made a few small technical mistakes, but in the large scale of the game, he really should have won that game.
Yeah.
And it really wasn't his fault.
No, it wasn't.
If he didn't make the small mistakes he did, the outcome would have been exactly the same.
Yeah,
exactly.
85% of the time, he wins that game.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, in the end,
85.0%
85.0% of the time.
Yeah.
This time it was 0.0%.
I mean, in the end, there's nothing Raynad can do with any cards that Hunter has to counter like the 15 damage from the Alexstrasza and the 15 damage from Double Fireball Frostbolt. There's nothing he could have done.
Yeah, I mean, I know it was talked about like how Miracle Rogue was like a solitaire class. Well, Freeze Mage is more of a solitaire class than...
You think it's more solitaire than,
I think
than
so.
Miracle was?
Yeah, I think
really?
So.
Really? Yeah, well, I guess they don't really engage things on the board.
Just play your draw, just stall stuff.
It's not as bad as with Miracle, though, because Miracle always takes so much time to actually play through your whole turns with drawing so many cards and all that. And Freeze Mage just plays two cards at maximum and just passes the turn. So it's not as annoying as playing Miracle, I would say.
It's not a very interactive gameplay, but I think watching Freeze Mage is one of my favorite experiences in tournaments. So I don't mind at all.
Oh no, I love Freeze Mage. Yeah. Any deck that's really slow and kills you in a way that feels bad. That's
we haven't
like
seen
my
Tarzan in that deck though.
I'm sure Tarzan's in there.
He didn't draw that deep in the first game, and he still had 7 in the second.
Yeah.
And I also think there's some chance it's not in there, but I think that chance is low.
There's no chance that Tarzan
no
is
chance.
In that deck. There's 0% chance that that could be the case.
Can we get like maybe another significant figure on that?
It would be 0.0%.
Wow.
It's like Tarzan is so good in Freeze
Mage. From the master himself.
That's right. Well, actually, here's the thing, too. Savitz is just so much smarter than me that he's probably like, no, it's not that good. And then I'm like,
oh, that was a spot on.
Yeah, right?
Accent.
That was pretty good. Yeah.
Well, all right. I am curious what classes they brought, and it's too bad we can't review that.
Okay, so Savitz has left Warrior deck for sure.
Okay.
Obviously, Raynad still has that Hunter, and...
We should probably start writing that down.
Yeah, we probably should. We need some paper. You have your iPad, man. Just type it out.
Yeah.
Well, if there's a Warrior, probably wouldn't queue up with Hunter. Oh.
Oh, there we see
it. Or I would.
Well, it's a mid-rangey Hunter, so it's still, you know, you get your high mains out, and you can do it.
Isn't that actually... Yeah. Yeah, that is worse for the Warrior.
Yeah,
the
repetitive
damage from the high
mid-range.
Main is huge.
Yeah. Mm. So...
Yeah, it's not too bad actually. Like this is like an old matchup. Like if we like rewound the meta like 4 months.
Did he just throw away Fiery War Axe and Cruel Taskmaster then got them right back? Did I just see that?
I don't know.
I think I just saw that.
But why would you ever throw those two cards away?
I don't know. I'm so confused. It looked like I don't know. I don't know. I guess it's not even on the screen, so you guys don't even get to see it.
No, your computer, that the one that they're going off of, is a little bit slow.
It's kind of... I think the game is stuck, actually. Oh, boy. So many technical difficulties.
Well, sorry, we are in the game.
Well, if we can swap to my screen here, we're basically all good.
Yeah, we do see the warrior hand over here, Savit's warrior. But it is warrior versus hunter guys, and... I guess let's see. Yeah, I think ECOP's got to restart that. So okay, so we do see it now, and we actually see... Oh, we see
two warrior hands.
Yeah, we see two warrior... I'm like, whoa, that's a
good hunter
hand.
That's
a crazy mid-range hunter deck. Oh my god.
Never seen that one before.
The control warrior card's in it.
Yep.
The shield blocks are very brave.
Yeah. So I like it. I think it's a great start for Warrior.
Yeah, absolutely.
That's so much armor. That's a lot of mid-game to counter the mid-game of the Hunter.
Yeah, and I mean, he even gets to proc the trap with a crappy little 2-2 dude that you could even end up playing again.
I don't know if we're sure that it is a freeze trap, though. Are we?
We can just check.
No, we can't. Right,
no, we can.
Unknown entity.
Whoa. Card type equals what?
Card type equals invalid.
Wow. That sounds really powerful.
It was a zero mana secret, right?
Zero mana secret. What class would get that? Shaman needs zero mana secrets.
Yeah, they don't have enough totemic might type of cards.
Yeah.
That's true. You could have that. Yeah. Zero mana secret.
Oh, you could do some cool stuff with that. Zero mana secrets. What could be, like...
Like, give your healing totem one health. Zero mana secret when you're attacked.
Like, every time you attack, or just procs one time?
Zero mana. You can't give that much value.
Hmm.
You could have, like, a zero mana secret. When you're attacked, you spawn a 1-1 totem.
How about this? It's got a secret where it's zero mana. If your opponent has this, they lose the game. So then they can't play the Kazan Mystic.
You just have to think about, like, how much worse, like, Paladin secrets are compared to, like, Hunter. Like, the 1
it's
to 2 is huge,
yeah.
And the 0 to 1 is even bigger. So, like, if you're going to have zero mana secrets, they're going to be absolutely terrible.
They're going to be pretty bad.
Yeah.
All right, we got both classes back up for you guys, so sorry about those difficulties.
I want to see some 10 mana secrets. Imagine that. Holy crap.
What now?
All right, so...
You have to hit the high main.
You have to.
Absolutely have to.
What if you hit face and let the ping hit Sylvanas and then you execute it with that coin?
I was actually thinking that, but I couldn't say that. You had to be the one to say it.
Yeah.
I had to be the one thinking. You could execute.
I think that's a good play, man. I think you should try it.
I think that you should try it and then, like, be just about to rope when you decide to finally do it and then be like, no, this is my life. Do you think this is better than using execute on the high main?
I'm actually surprised to see... Oh, actually, no, you do shield main because it's a freeze trap. The freeze trap is still left.
Yeah.
I was going to say, I think I'd rather prefer Sylvanas, but no, absolutely not.
Yeah.
The battle cry effect, you want that battle cry another time in this matchup.
The execute was a viable option, though, because taking 6 damage from a high main is not really what you want to do.
I think I would have done it that way. But I'm not exactly sure. I mean, it is a mid-range hunter, so the execute will have good targets later, but saving 6 life is pretty cool.
Keep in mind, you still have to enable that execute, though. And right now, Savis doesn't have anything to enable it.
Yeah.
I mean, Reyna's got a Sylvanas in his hand, so that execute might be pretty good soon. I don't know if you guys noticed that part. I thought that was maybe a little bit unusual.
Yeah, that is a little bit unusual.
I think that's actually unusual enough to assume that his deck has Feign Death in it.
Whoa.
It's high main, Sylvanas, Haunted Creeper, and Shredder.
Death.
It has to be at least one Feign Death. It's just
probably
too good.
Dr. Boom in there as well. So
that goes without saying, right?
I guess so.
Doesn't even need Feign Death. If there's high main, there's a Boomster.
Mm.
Okay.
Oh, Harrison Jones being drawn. Pretty good against that weapon.
Yeah.
Can't even draw 2 cards off of it thanks to the trap rocking right now.
Yep.
Yeah,
you can probably choose to just armor up big time here instead of Harrison. I don't really like it, though. I think I'd like Harrison better.
No, the Harrison is actually going to prevent 3 damage straight up anyways. Or even maybe six. If you're
no,
playing
I think
next turn,
I think
so.
If Reyna doesn't have lethal, he's not going to use his weapon charge. So I think you prevent the same amount of damage.
No, but if it's going to go up to two as soon as you attack in, because you're going to attack in.
That's what I'm saying. You may not attack in and then not play Harrison, I think, is the option.
I've never seen anyone not attack as much as you. You actually love to just never attack versus Hunter Secrets.
Well, the decks that I play are usually ones that are capable of gaining like 140 life.
Yeah, that's me too.
So, yeah.
You're my spirit animal, Crib. No, I think you have to do this, though, right? Like, I think that this is actually just
this
superior.
Seems like the obvious play, but I think the other play isn't really that bad.
Yeah, it prevents a little bit more damage, immediate damage, but long-term-wise, I think it does less than Harrison would right now.
Shield block?
And actually, yeah.
All right.
He got rewarded by drawing a shield block that he can coin out.
Do you actually like that? I think I liked the... The coin armor shield slam the 2-2. Two, two.
I prefer really that 1,000,000%.
It seems to me that Savis is really afraid of something like kill command, I guess. Mm.
But if you only gain two and you removed one of these, that's like only one armor
less.
Yeah,
it's only one armor less, and
you've
you still have the shield block.
Yeah. It seemed good to me that way. But Which secret is this on the hunter? It's another freezing, right?
Yeah, it is another freeze trap.
Okay, yeah. God, he's getting low. I
wonder. Yeah, the mid-range hunter generally has a really good, nice matchup against warrior, against the classic control warrior at least, thanks to those big minions being so hard to handle.
Mm.
Especially in the high main.
He needs to pop that shredder and get a doomsayer out. I wonder. Or Lightwell or something.
Armor made to fit. The whirlwind stuff.
Huh.
He can actually clear here with the axe and double shield slam.
Ooh, and that's a pretty weak drop out of there.
Yeah, below average for sure. Double shield slam being used just to get rid of the damage on the board. But this is big removal that cannot be used on big minions anymore.
Hostile Strider. Oh yeah, that came out of the...
What? No. Okay. No, that's a beast.
Yeah, yeah.
You play that because you also play Rhino. I have no time for
games. Wait, what? No, there's a Rhino is not in there. I'm sorry, Crypt, that's not the case.
Okay.
Hunter's Mark face attack? Oh wait, no.
Alright, well, actually the Warriors in really good spot right now. I think the Warriors just got to the point where the game is fairly well stabilized. I wonder.
Did he? Is he at that spot? Because this is just going to bounce. Like, if he could kill the Sylvanas. But that's like...
Like, he's got so much armor in hand, and the Hunter's out of cards.
Hmm.
Yeah, it's true. Double Shield Maiden definitely being a very annoying factor in this matchup right now.
Wow, Sylvanas.
Yeah, he can't play Sylvanas though, right?
I think he is. He's going to.
Because there's seven...
It nullifies the next play, which is so important, because next turn you could do an Axe to kill the 1-1, a Shield Maiden. I have no time for games. And then armor up.
But what if his opponent plays, like, Kill Command and a Beast? Right, that would just be death.
Yeah, exactly.
So I felt like that was a little bit risky, but I guess...
Oh, yeah, we knew you had the Beast, so I guess it'd be on the draw. Have we seen a single Kill Command? I don't think we have. I think there really may not be Kill Command.
He might not even run it. Considering that he runs double Hunter's Mark. So that might be his way of just...
Okay. Kill Command to kill a Sludge Belcher or something.
Yeah, exactly. So just instead of doing that and paying 3 mana for it, he wants to... just use less mana and kill minions.
That sounds like a Reynad-esque move.
And he does have the quick shot after all, so maybe that's like the kill command replacement.
Hmm. Alright, well, that play enabled this, so you have to use the axe to kill the 1-1. You go to 2 life, Sylvanas trades for Sylvanas. Ooh.
Oh. Oh, wow. Oh. Actually, he just straight can take Sylvanas. That's pretty sick.
Is he gonna get it?
Yeah, he can actually just force his way into it.
You do have to armor up first. That part's somewhat relevant. Yeah.
I guess that is right. I would be so excited I'd just do it and kill myself on the juggler.
Yeah, that was actually the only way you could do that.
Yeah, that was really good.
It was the shield block top deck.
Sick.
But it wasn't enough mana to do that otherwise.
Oh, that is a really important draw right there. Sylvanas won't be able to steal anything though, because of Death Rattle from the.
Unless
it doesn't matter. Wait, it's Belcher time.
Yeah, with a double shield maiden especially, it's just... Savi's just got this game locked up.
Yeah, it looks like it.
You think you'd trade anyway into the high main?
Yeah. I think you just remove everything. Because if you look at his hand, he's never going to lose. If he just keeps clearing the board every turn. He just has way too much armor gain. I have to say, I kind of feel bad for Raynad so far in the series. Like, the fireball top deck, and now this game just overall was like a little bit.
I can take the hit.
A little bit sad. Get him down to 3
Warrior
health.
Bounces back to 12.
Yep.
He's going to be an Alistraz in one of these turns. Oh, that looks like a not so good draw there.
No, that's.
not really.
That wasn't the best draw in the deck.
And more armor.
All right, watch Raynad's face. No, he's staying pretty calm.
Well, maybe he's saving the best for last.
And now it's 17 health to 21 health.
Master. Oh god. Man.
Ouch.
His draw is so terrible.
Yeah.
Feels like I'm playing ranked right now. There's really not too much you could do about that.
That was rough. That was very rough.
Yeah, indeed.
I think either Saviz knows the deck he's playing against, because I really think there's no kill commands in there, or he's already probably correctly assumed that there's no kill commands in there.
I think there is no kill commands.
Yeah, he's just seeing all those cards that mid-range hunters don't usually run.
Yeah.
Like double hunter's mark and quick shot. So he's just naturally assuming that there has to be something that's not in there.
Yeah, like his deck doesn't even... Well, I mean, he has plenty of beasts in there that he could run it, but...
Yeah, if you run Houndmaster, it's probably going to run Kill Command, but at the same time, it's a card that people always play around, and I've noticed that like removing the very obvious cards actually serves a really big advantage, and it's like the biggest surprise you can have.
Yeah, think about it for a second.
Like, I made Pirate Paladin, removed Consecrate.
People will always play around it.
Yeah.
You got to assume there's Consecrate in there.
It worked for a while.
But, like, I guess, you know, a lot of times Kill Command actually will be used for 3 damage because they'll just keep clearing all the beasts. So it's like, well, why not do 3 damage for 2 mana and possibly draw a card? It makes sense. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So we will see Saviz's last deck here.
Yep. Saviz on his final deck. But that means that's a good thing in the Conquest format. On the final deck means it's match point for that player.
Yeah. Okay. Wow, that's very, very reverse.
Yeah, it is.
From last
it?
Hero Standing.
So Saviz is on his last deck. Do you remember what it may have been?
You wrote it down, right, Ecop?
I didn't write it down, sorry.
I could have sworn that we...
The thing I'm starting to notice with the Conquest format is when there's so many new things, when like there's new cards coming out that you can like try to take big risks, it seems like when you fail and take a risk, it's a big problem. Like, it seems like this Hunter deck doesn't really work all that well right now, and it has to win a game because it's Conquest.
Yeah, that's true. He doesn't just get a buy.
Yeah, exactly. So if you maybe use one of the new Blackrock cards because you think they might be good and they turn out not to be good, you might just not be able to beat anyone.
I mean, if anyone can do it with midrange hunter, I think it's Raynad. He's been known for playing a lot of midrange hunters throughout Hearthstone history, and with Blackrock Mountain and the added quick shot that he pulled off, I think he might have found a build that's viable.
And it just might be, we knew I was getting pretty unlucky. We were seeing that.
He should have
beat Mage. But I'm realizing that in the general case, especially with this tournament format, and especially in the timing, that we might see some ridiculous risks really not pay off.
Yeah.
Well, that would be exciting. I want to see ridiculous risks both pay off and not pay off. I like the whole range. Yeah. I want the entire experience this weekend.
Yeah.
I didn't fly all this way to watch the same old crap kill each other.
Really?
No.
It's still Hunter.
This is a very different hunter, isn't it?
At least it's not Face Hunter.
Yeah.
Come on.
No Smork today.
This is Lost Talstrider Hunter, as far as we can tell.
Yep. Nope, still Hunter. Hunter versus Pally. Oh, man.
Oh, God.
Oh, boy.
Oh, my God. Of course he's playing this deck.
That looks like a good hand.
Yeah, it's not too bad.
Well, you can coin out the juggler, actually, because you can protect him immediately.
That is true.
Holy cow.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, guys. Look at this. I'm sure y'all have played this on the ladder a little bit.
I think I still like the coin out the juggler.
It looks like we actually have this upside down. Yeah, Rain Knight is actually the hunter, so we'll get that switched in just a moment.
Savi's final deck is the Paladin and Aggro Paladin, which he has been performing fairly well with on both ladder. And he also played it in Kingwing Pro League, if I recall correctly.
We also haven't seen Glaive Zuka in the Hunter deck.
Yeah, it's definitely not in there, I would say. And look at that, the quick shot being pretty useful.
Pretty good.
I'm so excited for this Hobgoblin.
I think you got to ooze here, even though it's like crazy synergy with Hobgoblin.
Yeah,
you got to
take
control as fast as possible, and that's the hardest one to get rid of.
It is. It's a heartbreaker to do. Nothing in the world feels like echoing ooze with Hobgoblin. It's just a fantastic thing to do. But no, you're right. I mean, you've got to just not play too greedy here. He only needs to pick up one win, and this deck is like one that definitely can pick up one win.
Oh, man. That Unleash is probably going to have to be used. Oh, no, you can't. You can't even use it. Hobgoblin has no answer. If he goes for the YOLO Gobbo, it has no answer right now.
And he already saw some... you won't do it, though, because you know he's even playing Houndmaster, right? You know he's playing two quick shots, Houndmaster.
Mukla's a card that's in there for Divine Favor, by the way, mostly.
Yes, of course, yeah.
But, okay.
Like, no, it's just his favorite NPC from World of Warcraft, Crypt. Jeez. Don't you make your decks like that for tournaments?
Oh, boy. The funny
part of that statement is I actually know where King Mukla is from in World of Warcraft, and it's, like, the most nonsense quest. It's the most minuscule part of, like, a small area in Wrath of Lich King and Sholazar Basin. Just, like, you kill a bunch of baby gorillas, and, like, Mukla comes out, and then you
kill Mukla.
He's, like, super easy to kill. There's, like, nothing.
Oh.
Yeah.
Why would you kill baby gorillas?
get Mukla.
It's like Congo, the movie. Remember that movie? They all come out to defend the diamonds.
Apparently they're not threatened by extinction in Azeroth.
Huh?
Apparently they're not threatened by extinction.
Oh. Yeah. Well, they are after Crypt got through with them. Alright, so look at those two... if this was like the Hunter deck that he just played against... Those web spinners got him some pretty sick stuff, but...
Yeah, imagine Reynard had one of his Hunter's Marks against this King Mukla, actually.
Yeah.
That would be pretty huge.
He's just not drawing quite right here. This is a little bit painful.
Now, if you got Hobgoblin, you really want to save the Argent Squire. You might even want to save the Annoyatron, but if you save both, as you play nothing. So you kind of have to play one, and it looked like he is playing the Annoyatron. That does seem to be the better fit.
If
you do the Annoyatron... I think you just got to take out the 2-1 Dougie. Mm-hmm. And dude.
Of course, dude. What about going to face? Like, just empty your hand out here.
Yeah, just double abusive.
Go
to face for 9.
Yeah, because the Annoyatron is going to clean up, like, 2 to 3 guys. Yeah.
No.
Yeah, no, you're... Yeah, Crip, yeah, it's the right play. Thank you, Ecob.
Totally, that's Ertol's play
this
right
is
there.
This is the right play.
Wow.
Yeah. You don't dude here. You go to face...
He's not going... Oh.
Yeah, he does.
Okay.
He's at 26. Why do you need to prevent 2 damage with a Mukla? What? Crip, you are so turtly right now. You need to put away the Gengar Brogue.
So he's just... he didn't see Hunter's Mark there to deal with that Mukla. He took the risk. And he got... apparently, he's just all in on this Mukla right now.
Dude, you got to play that King of the Beast. Look at you. You got 4 beasts. You got to do it. You have to. It's a taunt.
Yeah?
You have to play
that
card.
Becomes a 6-6?
You have to play it. If you do any
King
other play here,
beasts.
It's wrong. I am so sure of this right now.
Maybe he just thinks in his head that King of Beasts is such a bad card, you never want to play it.
Dude, it gets... hold on, let's just... I never actually see this card. Yeah, man. Oh, God, yes. Of course you have to play that. Of course.
Yeah.
If he plays Houndmaster and Banana, I'm like, wait, but that's a smaller taunt, so why would we do that?
Yeah, it looks like he's not playing that, though. He likes the Banana.
Oh, no, he's got to play King of the Beasts. He must just be afraid of divine favor or something, right? Like, if he's doing that.
He just doesn't know how good it is?
He just doesn't get it. Oh, great nad. This game is yours with King of the Beasts.
Yeah, looks like he's going for the abusives. And just wants to get that taunt up to not take too much damage from the King Mukla.
That would have been so big, too. I'm incredibly sad right now, guys. That King of the Bees could have just swung this game right around.
I'm still so against the 9 face damage.
No.
I agree with your crib, honestly.
Oh, you guys.
Like, those abusives have to hit, like, once, and then they're worth it.
All right, Hobgoblin in action right now. We're probably going to see this Blessing of Might cast on the
Divine Shield,
on Divine Shield minion. Oh, actually on the Hobgoblin.
Yeah, because he doesn't want to kill for free.
Yeah. That's good. And now all he needs to do is draw a Divine Favor and just laugh all the way to the bank. Or the winner bracket match, you know, whichever.
So I'm pretty sure we're just going to see double trades here. Hobgoblin and...
Mukla
being put into the bin and then just...
I really feel this game is like unbelievably one-sided right now.
You don't think he should freeze and trap here? Are you going to get anything better than the 3-3 divine?
What gave it away, Crip? Was it the five cards in hand for Reynard and 0 cards
like,
for Paladin?
No, I know the Paladin has some comeback mechanics with like divine favor and a lot of small stuff, but I think even then it's going to struggle. I think it's almost no chance.
So Reynard had the option of just playing the Hymen there, but he chose to go for Shredder and Freezing Trap, which is good too.
Yeah.
First of all, because you handle that 3-3 Divine Shield minion pretty well with the Freezing Trap. And also, you don't give your opponent that many cards with a Divine Favor that you might top deck.
Yeah. I definitely think that's a far superior play there. And he knows it's Freezing too, so he's like, "Ah, you gotta do it though. You got to do it.
You can wait, I guess.
I think you just do it, because he'll remove your dudes for days.
Let's see what pummels out of the Shredder.
Oh, you got to be kidding me. This is like...
Here
of course
comes.
It's Milhouse Mana Storm.
Kill Command. Kill Command. Who would have guessed?
How did he fit all these cards in? Is this a 35-card deck?
Maybe there's no Dr. Boom.
Yeah, maybe.
We haven't seen it.
Oh, jeez. Okay.
Sick.
Well, that's a way to come back, but is it too much damage for Reynard already? Let's count.
Actually,
that Gazrilla is pretty scary.
Kill Commanding Gazrilla is more damage than Kill Commanding Face.
That's true.
He almost has, I think he's 2 off lethal.
Well, that's Kill Command, that is
12, 13, 14, 15. 2 off. He doesn't quite have it.
No, not quite.
I don't think you would kill Command this.
Well, there's no point.
So Reynard just keeping up with the game plan he had. Trying to freeze that Arcane Squire and putting enough damage on the board to threaten lethal right now.
Alright. Someone in the other room is actually yelling about this game.
Oh boy.
Let me think.
Well, I mean, I guess you can taunt some stuff, right?
It is. The biggest taunt you can play is Coghammer right away.
But does it matter if it's big? He's just dead anyways. He has a silence.
Well, he's got 2 taunts, though.
Oh, yeah. Look at that. He's still dead, though. Kill Command.
Yep.
Oh, wait, no. They're both Divine Shield.
That should be good, right?
That's enough.
Yeah.
He can BM with Gazrilla, Kill Command Gazrilla for an overkill of, I think, 7. I know.
So 9. He doubles it, right?
You have the silence one, then double attack the other one, and then Kill Command plus attack.
Oh, please do it, Reynard. Come on, Reynard.
He's going to do it. He's going to do it. Don't worry.
Come on. Please don't Kill Command face. Don't let down your fans.
There you go. Yes. There you have
24
it.
24 damage.
Sick.
Bam.
And... that is why Web Spinner is just so much fun.
Now it's evened up. Both players are on their final decks.
That's right, yeah. So it's going to be like the crazy aggro pally.
Yep.
going up against. What was Rainan's last deck? ECOP?
We don't know, do we?
I could ask you the same thing, Artosis.
Yeah, but I did it first, ECOP, so.
Oh, man.
I guess we're about to find out right now.
I always feel like Artosis knows when he's just like testing us. If he saw that like one frame in the intro.
These guys are so unprofessional, they don't know the final deck. I'm going to teach them a lesson by not saying what it is.
Okay.
Well, I want to just get into this last game here. This is actually really close. Here's the true question. Who deserves to win this series?
Who deserves to win?
Who deserves it?
What defines a deserving player?
That's up to you guys.
Because if it's, you know, if it's like no misplays kind of stuff, it's a bit too traditional, you know?
I say neither of them deserves to win. Just ended in double disqualification.
Yeah. It turns out we're just going to put
Crip
into the
players in the tournament.
Exactly.
Oh, man. Oh, Mage.
Oh, okay. Let's see. Is it going to be Mech?
No. Nope.
Well.
Tempo.
Yeah, okay.
Oh, this is a deck that has risen in popularity in recent days, for sure. A lot of players have been like not been playing Mech Mage as the aggro mage of choice anymore. Instead, it's switching around to the tempo mage.
Yeah.
I feel like the Mech Mage has a lot of advantages that this doesn't, though. I don't think it's like just better. I think it's just.
It's different.
Yeah. Different.
Mech Mage often enough to that's also like a downside. Mech Mage has the upside of Mech Mage is that it has more powerful potential with it, but it all depends on the draws that you get. Mm. So if you have a weak draw with Mech Mage, if you don't curve out properly, it's really hard to actually get a big enough advantage for your opponent to not be able to come back from.
Ooh, look at that double Jeeves draw from Saviz. It's not very cool.
Yeah, that's pretty horrible.
Ooh, and he fired.
And right there we see one of my favorite cards, at least, Ekop of Medivh.
Ekop of Medivh.
Yeah. That's right.
Pretty sure that's not what
the card
says. You
know what's my favorite
is
when you get two leper nymphs with that. I'll show them all! Over your head, I guess. I don't know.
Yeah, and Reynard actually playing the version that he initially popularized, I think. The one that really likes to flood the board. A lot of cheap stuff, especially Mirror Image in combination with Echo of Medivh. Mm. It's a really good combination.
Yeah, that's actually really cool.
Reporting for duty. And being able to play it all for cheap with the help of Sorcerer's Apprentice.
Now, those counterspells are going to be pretty big. Because the Flood Mage often has a huge hand, but at the same time, the Paladin doesn't have that many spells. Divine Favor might just get swallowed up.
You see Mirror Entity being pulled from the Mage Scientist.
Oh, whoa!
Whoa, Mogur the Ogre.
That card is actually really good against a bunch of small minions, because they can never actually kill the mid-game minions. They just keep attacking the wrong stuff all the time.
Wow.
Yeah, keep
that
in mind.
Could be pretty sick.
Keep
that
in mind
cool
that counts for both
going.
Players.
Yep.
Oh my god.
Double G's.
This game is just getting crazy fast.
The only reason Double G's. The only way Double G's is anything, I think, is if you have no cards in your deck. Right?
Yeah, I guess that would be.
Or does
right.
it double trigger off itself?
Hmm. No, I don't think so. I think that one of them triggers and then you draw up. Mm-hmm. To three, and then the other one just doesn't trigger.
I know in some of the patchwork kills, people run double Jeeves, and patchwork tries to draw three times twice.
Wait, what?
So double Jeeves works if you have no cards in your deck and in your hand.
That would definitely work.
Yeah.
So what do you think? Does Reyna just slam the ogre here? After attacking, obviously.
Hmm.
I think so. It's the most powerful play, I guess, because it got cheaper by Unsealed Portal.
I think it's also important to keep your 3-2 alive.
Yeah.
But you keep alive no matter what.
What to do?
Like, Mogur the Ogre gives you the potential of just...
how much health does he have?
Of just saving as many of your minions as you can, so you can get a better Urko of Medivh as well.
I really think Mogur would be, like, pretty nuts if his stats were flipped.
Yeah, like a 6-7, that's way better.
Yeah.
The Boulder Fist Mogur.
Boulder Fist Mogur. I was trying to think of a joke like that. That's good. You're fast. Ooh.
Time runs out on me. Can I kill the dude here?
Yeah, of course.
Just in case there might be a quartermaster.
Yeah, I kind of doubt that in this deck.
Kind of doubt it.
Yeah, there's none.
But it is the right play,
it's technically correct.
It is technically correct, Grip. That is right. Yeah, that girl in my sixth grade class is sat in the front row. Like, well, actually. Like, oh, thanks, Crip.
Oh, here's going to be a bit of a mess.
This is going to be fun.
Here's where it gets really messy. It's going to be like...
Oh, all right, just hits perfectly.
Damn. I was hoping to be both the 1-1s just accidentally kill the Jeeves, and then your Jeeves kills itself on the Moger. Oh.
That would be pretty funny. Oh, God, this is so crazy.
Oh, boy. So hard to decide. How do I attack? Do you just always assume you're gonna?
It's only one in four that it screws up big time. So,
but do you always like? How do you attack against Moger? Do you just always assume you're attacking right?
Oh. Okay, good.
Right to the face.
That was probably ideal, actually.
By the way, there you have it. Wisp being played. Real tournament. Real match. Didn't know that we'd ever see the day. Let me get that.
Okay.
Moger is so awesome, man. I'm loving this right now.
Oh! Nope. Ripless. Moger, you're not attacking Jeeves today.
I think the Hobgoblin is the most dangerous thing on the board.
Yeah, it is.
Definitely is, especially with all the cards that Savis is able to draw off of that Jeeves.
Look at this big... Oh my god, he's going to have... Oh. This is just crazy, guys. Watch this,
He's going to try to Coghammer the Ooze. If it
that
hits
would
the
be
ooze,
insane.
It would be completely insane.
That would be so crazy.
It'd be a
Come
two, three,
on,
four cock
hammer.
Divine.
Oh, whoa.
You
gotta
be kidding me.
Oh, Raynad does not respond.
My god.
If that was Ecop up there, man, he would be shaking his head and holding it. I know exactly what you'd be like.
Honestly, though, I would be just laughing my ass off because Moger or the Ogre is on the board.
Wow.
Just doing some crazy stuff.
Yeah, Moger just did nothing. He just saw the Sludge Belcher take a horrible death. I don't know if you guys noticed.
Wow, yeah.
And Moger's about to kill himself on a Divine Shield taunt here in a second.
Well, we'll see. He might just attack something else. Moger can go through stuff.
Yeah, he might go for the 4-1 Jeeves, perhaps. But Moger's not staying alive through this turn, I don't think.
I don't know. He might.
So Jeeves popping the shield as intended.
See, you can't pop the shield and kill the 4-1. Something bad's going to happen to Moger here, guys.
the hero power.
I think you're right.
With the hero power, he can pop the second shield, ensuring that Moger doesn't run into one of those.
Oh, okay. That's good.
And now what does Moger... Oh, actually, he's not going for that.
Oh, he's not even going to attack.
Oh, okay.
He wants Moger to really get...
Time for Super Jeeves.
Oh, my God. I love it.
Oh my goodness. Double Hobgoblin.
Come on, Jeeves. 5-8. Give that Jeeves some axes, man. Oh my god.
Dude, Jeeves is pretty buff, man.
That Jeeves right now is like an Alfred or something. Like that Jeeves is driving the Batmobile at the moment.
Oh, that's bad.
How must it feel to lose to such a cheesy deck like Aggro Paladin? Damn.
Well, we can ask him after, I guess.
Yeah, we can.
Moger has made this a very interesting game.
Yeah, it looked at the start like it was favoring Raynad, but unfortunately, the first couple of attacks did not favor him that much. So Moger
lives.
Oh boy.
Oh, not Leprenome though.
Oh man. Wait, does Moger affect? Hero weapon
no.
attacks?
No, it just doesn't. Creatures. Oh, no!
Oh, Moger.
Poor Hobgoblin. How do you deal with a 5-8 Jeeves? I don't even think there's, like, removal in that deck.
Yeah, like a Polymorph, but I don't think Raynad runs it.
Yeah, I don't think so.
It's almost Kel'Thuzad's stats right there. Oh, boy.
Seriously.
It's probably worse than Kel'Thuzad. You actually have to like waste your turns killing the garbage minions, but he keeps getting more of them.
Oh man! Wait, what is that? Is that a counterspell?
Yeah, it is.
Okay.
Doesn't matter.
Such a rough turn.
Oh my god, this Hobgoblin is just gaining so much. Hello. Guys, I miss Moger right now. I wanted this attack phase to be a little bit more cool.
Well, Moger survived for a long, long time, so...
Yeah, that's true.
That was lethal if it wasn't Counterspell or Spellbender, but he had tested for, I think, just about everything else besides Ice Block. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, pretty good.
All right, well, this is the last turn here for...
Reporting for duty.
For Raynad.
Let me get that.
Here we go, Deathwing.
That does...
Would Deathwing not be the sickest?
Oh!
What? That's not bad.
He can actually play that and heal himself back up to 15.
Yep.
And wait, there'd be 5, 8, 9, 10.
Turn 8 Alistraza from a stable
lethal,
portal.
Though. It's still lethal on board.
Is it?
Yeah. It's still like exact.
Oh, is that the True Silver? Yeah, it is the True Silver. Okay.
Yeah, it is exact.
Yeah, it's exact lethal. Oh, well.
Forson's back there. It's like, what? Alistraza? I've never been lucky before in my life. How does he get that?
Never lucky. But yeah, this is certainly not damage. It's exact 15.
Yep. All right, as long as it's not ace block, which it's not.
Savise. Oh my god.
That was a close one.
So, I mean, as...
It was a closer series than we expected, I guess.
As it turns out, a 5-8 Jeeves is pretty good.
Yeah, he's not too bad.
Yeah.
That was a pretty sick... set of hobgoblins, no doubt.
Yeah, the hobgoblins, the Mogre. This game was full of insanity.
Dude, that series was a little bit crazy, I have to say.
Yeah. Well, congratulations, Savise. The defending champion has defended his first round.
Yeah, we had actually, when you think about it, right, Gazrilla actually ended a game, and that was off a web spinner, and then Mogre the Ogre like really changed things in that game, and that was off Unstable Portal.
Yeah.
Yeah,
and as we know, Piloted Shredder will probably affect this tournament more than any other
card. Those were some pretty sick unstable portals, though, getting two legendaries.
Yeah.
Who can get that lucky?
Savitz, come sit with us. All right, so that was a pretty interesting match. Top deck Fireball, talk to us about that. Because I was like, oh, it looks like Raynad may finally get a tournament victory over Savitz.
Yeah, that was pretty sick, and I couldn't come up with anything else. I knew I have exactly one Fireball left. I used one on the high man. Yeah. And, I just had to go for it. When I was setting up the ice blocks and I had another one in my hand, I knew that I had a lot of draws, like earlier on, with like Blood Mage, so I could like Frostbolt Ping and stuff like that. I don't remember exactly what, but there was a lot of outs. But then I like down to that moment, I knew that it's 1 out of 8, and it was like my best chance that I got lucky this time.
Yeah, and that's 15%.
I was pretty surprised you held off Alistraza so long. I thought you could maybe go for it early on. Do you think like that's the way you like to play the game, where you just stall out as late as you can with the Alistraza?
I can't quite remember it, but I think that I was trying to set up so that he can't pop the block. I wanted to find a turn where I can Alistraza and be confident that he can't like pop the ice block with Kill Command. So I was like kind of trying to do some math there. I don't remember exactly. Maybe my math was off, but that was like the general idea, because I knew that I don't have 15 damage in my hand, because I was forced to use like the Ice Lance a bit earlier. But maybe I burned my first Nova too quickly, and like I only had 2 1-1s, but the problem was that my hand was full, so I needed to get rid of one card. But that kind of came back to haunt me in a bit, like burning that Nova so early.
There was actually a game with the Warrior deck where you armored like a funny amount or something. Do you remember this turn?
Oh, yes.
And we were like, does he have...
It was the Hyena play, right?
If he has a... Oh, yeah, like you... No, wait, I can't quite remember, but it was like basically came down to if he had Kill Command, you were dead. Did you think he didn't have Kill Command?
Yeah, we were actually thinking that he may not have had Kill Command as well.
Yeah, that's like... I don't know about that. I would still guess that it's in there. But I don't know if you remember the Sylvanas play, like when I dropped Sylvanas instead of like the Shield Maidens.
Yeah.
At that point, I had it figured out that he does not have a burn spell in his hand.
Yeah.
It was like when I went for like the ridiculous double Shield Slams on like the small ones, I was doing the math that I need to clear as much as I can so he can't like quick shot hero power me. I knew that Kill Command would kill me earlier, but that Sylvanas was a bit like risky because I knew that he only has one card in his hand and that's from the web spinner, so I think that it was okay. So I was like a bit like trying to block the future creatures with it or force him to trade.
Yeah,
very well played indeed.
What we were referring to was. It was like the end of the turn, so it was like a bit frantic and that you even remember, but you chose to coin out the shield block that you drew from something else rather than armor up and then coin the shield slam into a hyena, because you'd only have one less health, but you'd save the shield block.
I can't recall the exact state, but that that shield block was a bit like rush. But I think that I didn't have the shield block, and I just like just drew it from something.
Just drew it and just
rope burning. Probably not worth the coin shield block there.
Yeah.
I think it was a misplay, but it was like a bit rushed, and I was just like, okay, I need to get my health total up or something.
So now the really important question on everyone's mind: how do you play versus Smoker the Ogre?
Oh God. I'm so scared that he actually has one in his deck and he's gonna drop it after I kill the first one. I don't know, like I was at some point I was kind of trying to figure it out that it might actually work for my advantage. But I don't know. I'm kind of speechless about right. I need to think about that a little bit more.
Like, what's your mindset when going into the attacks? What do you attack? Do you want to attack the stuff that you want to attack, or do you want to attack the stuff that you don't want to attack?
The thing was that we both had chiefs, which was one of the chiefs was from the mirror entity, and with the attacks that I was doing, I was trying to make sure that at least one of the chiefs would be alive at the end of turn. So I didn't want I was trying to be careful there with those attacks, like choosing to put the Blessing of Might, for example, on my own chief so that it just like doesn't run into the Mogor and then my other buffed minion runs into his chiefs or so. So I was trying to like keep one of the chiefs alive at that point, even though I did have another one in my hand.
So what made you decide that Paladin, Aggro Paladin, the class that deck that you've been running a lot on ladder and also in some tournament, what made you decide to bring this kind of deck? Because it's often regarded as like kind of a, I don't know, some sort of cheesy or bad deck. And what made you decide to bring it here to Zitzera Cup?
Well, the origins for that were just like raw stats, because I actually have like insane win rate with it on ladder, and I hit legend with it this morning. I was like 9 wins in a row. It's like, okay, there are a couple of bad matchups, but both of the like the worst matchups are out of the meta right now, and also like Tarzan is like the most meta-defining card right now, and by turn 6, when my opponent chooses to play Tarzan, usually like the Paladin has already done his thing. Mm. So like Tarzan-based decks are usually really bad against. So that was like the main meta call.
Mm. All right, very nice.
Cool.
So congratulations on your first victory. You're going to face the winner of was it Powder versus who was it?
Oh, I can't remember now.
It's Powder versus Vortex.
Oh, okay.
So what do you think of those players? Who's going to win this?
They are both pretty good, but I think that I have a big advantage going into it. But I don't care which one I play.
Are you looking forward to see to play against Vortex again to avenge your loss for the Assembly?
Sure. But I would be fine to play Powder too.
All right.
Cool. All right.
Congratulations
so,
again.
Yeah, congrats, Savitz. We'll see if you win in, I think he's going to be playing the third match now after we do match
something
two.
Like
but
that.
First, we do have to go to a quick little commercial break, I think, while we get the next one set up. So, guys, don't go away. Make sure you tell your friends to get in here, and we'll see you shortly.